Well, it really doesn't matter what it means to you. We don't worship you. We worship the true God. And if he says it's an abomination, then it's an what? Abomination. Just pure and simple. Now, I don't know too many people who nowadays would believe that story, especially if your daughter tried to tell it to you. But this was the story, that she became pregnant with the rays of the sun. Now, she gave birth to Tammuz on December 25th. That is the birthday of the Babylonian sun god, December 25th. And I think it's important probably to point out, see, we went into captivity in Babylon. We were involved in the worship of Tammuz. We know his birthday was December 25th. We came out of Egypt. We know that the Egyptian sun god Ra was born on December 25th. The Romans hung us on the cross, which was the sign of the Roman sun god Mithra, who was born on December 25th. They sacrificed Jews to their sun god Mithra, born on December 25th. And Antiochus Epiphanes came into Jerusalem, slaughtered a pig on the altar in 168 BC, and set up a statue of Zeus, the Greek sun god, on December 25th, his birthday. Now, there's one day I will guarantee you that Jesus of Nazareth was not born. It's December 25th. That's why if Western Gentile Christians attempt to try to witness to Jews and they have Jesus dressed up in a bunch of pagan sun god garments, then don't blame them if they don't believe it, because you've got him dressed up looking like a pagan sun god. They're not supposed to be worshiping pagan sun gods, and don't dress Jesus up like that. He was born on Tishri 15, and if you can't celebrate his birthday on the right date, then don't celebrate any pagan sun god's birthday.